Friends, today we will do a few numericals on air cycles, thermodynamic cycles. We will take up these problems from the old question papers of thermal engineering. Thermal engineering, April May 2017, section A, part A, question number 7. A Carnot engine working between 650 degree Kelvin and 300 degree Kelvin produces 100 kilojoules of work. 100 kilojoules of work. Full stop. Determine thermal efficiency of the cycle and heat added during the cycle or heat absorbed during the cycle carries 5 marks. This is the highest temperature of the cycle, that is T1. This is the lowest temperature of the cycle, that is T3. This is W. Now, we know Carnot cycle efficiency is T1 minus T3 divided by T1. That is, T1 is 650, substitute minus 300 divided by 650. So, take your calculator. 650 minus 300, 650 minus 300 is 350 divided by 650 equals 0.538. Or it is, if you want to give it in percentage into 100, 53.8%. This is the efficiency of the cycle. This is got. Next, we want heat added. Now, efficiency is equal to any cycle. For any cycle, efficiency is work done during the cycle divided by heat added during the cycle. Heat added during the cycle. So, heat added will be equal to work done by efficiency. Work done divided by efficiency. So, work done is given as 100 kilojoules. Efficiency, we got it as 0.538. 100 divided by 0.538. Will give us 100 divided by 0.538 is 185.87, or you can take it as 9, so many kilojoules. This is the heat added during the cycle. So this finishes that problem, carries 5 marks. April, May 2017, in the same paper, we have problem number 13B for 4 marks. The problem goes like this. In an auto cycle has a cylinder dia. Auto cycle has a cylinder dia of 150 mm, and stroke of 225 mm. The clearance volume is 1.25 into 10 to the power of minus 3 cubic meters. Calculate the air standard efficiency of the auto cycle take gamma is equal to 1.4. This is the problem for 4 marks on auto cycle. This is problem on auto cycle. Now for auto cycle, the efficiency of auto cycle, air standard efficiency of auto cycle is 1 minus 1 by r to the power of gamma minus 1. Here gamma is given, known. Gamma we know is 1.4, but r we do not know. First we have to get r, then we have to get the efficiency. Now these things are given to find r. Now r we know is Vs plus Vc divided by Vc. Now Vc is clearance volume, that is given. We have to find out Vs. So Vs is equal to pi d square by 4 into L. Now area into length of the stroke. This is in cubic meters. Which one? Vc is in cubic meters. So Vs also should be in cubic meters. So we will convert this into meters. This is 0.15 meter. This is 0.225 meters. Substitute here, pi into 0.15 square divided by 4 into 0.225. This will give us 5 into 0.15 square into 0.225 divided by 4 will give me 3.976 into 10 to the power of -3. So if you substitute here, 3.976 plus into 10 to the power of minus 3 plus 1.25 into 10 to the power of minus 3 divided by 1.25 into 10 to the power of minus 3. This is R. R is to be calculated from that formula. Now, the easiest way of doing it is, do one thing. This will be 3.976 plus 1.25, whole thing multiplied by 10 to the power of minus 3 divided by 1.25 into 10 to the power of minus 3, cancel both of them. Now it becomes easy. 3.976 plus 1.25 equals divided by 1.25 will give me 4.18. This is R, the compression ratio. Now substitute this in that formula, you get the air standard efficiency. So this will be 1 minus 1 by 4.18 to the power of 1.4 minus 1. Now 4.18 to the power of 0.4. 1.4 minus 1 is 0.4 is equal to this much. It comes 1.77 something. 1 by that equals 0.564. 1 minus answer will give me 0.435 something, that is 43.5% if you are giving in percentage. So that's it. This is the problem on auto cycle. April-May 2017, question number 14A on diesel cycle. The problem goes like this. An ideal diesel engine working on diesel cycle having cylinder bore 210 mm, piston stroke L 300, 330 mm, clearance volume VC is 7 × 10⁵ cubic mm, and cutoff takes place at 6% of stroke. 6% of stroke. Find the air standard efficiency of the cycle. Here, again, first we have to find out R. R will be Vs plus Vc divided by Vc. Now, Vc is given in cubic millimeter. So, we will not change this. We will keep it in cubic millimeter only. Vs will be equal to pi d square by 4 into L. You will get in cubic millimeter. This also can be got in cubic millimeter. If you don't change this, keep it like that. Then, it will be pi into 210 square divided by 4 into 330. So that will be pi into 210 square into 330 divided by 4. This is 11.43 into 10⁶. 10⁶, or I can make it as 114.3 into 10⁵, because this is 10⁵. I'll make this also 10⁵ cubic millimeter. Now R will be equal to Vs is 114.3 into 10⁵ plus 7 × 10⁵ divided by 7 × 10⁵. So 114.3 plus 7 × 10⁵ divided by 7 × 10⁵. I'll cancel this. So R will be 114.3 plus 7 equals this much divided by 7 will be 17.3. R is 17.3 I got. Now we have to find out one more ratio is to be found out, that is rho. So we got R. R is how much? 17.3. We have to find rho also. Gamma is not given. We can assume gamma as 1.4. Now to find rho, that is cutoff ratio, what we have to do. Now, if I draw the PV diagram, PV diagram for diesel cycle, this is the PV diagram. What he is telling is, this volume is 6% of this volume. This volume, cutoff volume, is 6% of stroke volume. Cutoff volume is 6% of stroke volume. So what I will do is, cutoff volume means V3 minus V2 is equal to 0.06 into V1 minus V2. Stroke volume means V1 minus V2. Now V3 minus V2 is equal to 0.06 into V1, because R is 17.3, V1 by V2 is 17.3, so V1 will be 17.3 V2 minus V2. So this will be V3 minus V2 is equal to 0.06 into 16.3 V2. So that works out to 0.06 into 16.3 works out to 0.978. This works out to 0.978 V2. So V3 is equal to 0.978 V2 plus V2. If I transfer this V2 that side, so V3 is equal to 1.978 V2, or V3 by V2 is equal to 1.978, or roughly 2. Now this is what we call rho, cutoff ratio. That is the cutoff ratio. Now what you have to do, we have to substitute these values in the air standard efficiency formula. The formula is air standard efficiency of diesel cycle is 1 minus 1 by R to the power of gamma minus 1 into rho to the power of gamma minus 1 divided by gamma into rho minus 1. So make the substitution, 1 minus 1 by 17.3 to the power of 1.4 minus 1 into rho, 1.978 to the power of 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 into rho minus 1. Rho is 1.978 minus 1. Now the calculation is to be done like this. First do it, 0.626, or I am getting 62.6%. This is the efficiency of the cycle. This is the answer he wants. This problem carries 7 marks. It carries 7 marks. One more problem. In the same year, April-May 2017, question number 14B. A Carnot engine operates with thermal efficiency of 70%. Carnot cycle engine operates with an efficiency of 70%. The minimum temperature, that is T3, is 30 degree centigrade. Sorry, T3 is 30 degree. This is not capital T3, it is small T3. Find the maximum temperature, T1 is how much. Now, this carries 3 marks. Now, we have this T3 will be equal to 30 plus 273, that will be 303 degree Kelvin. So, this is the, in this formula, it is always capital T, that is absolute temperature, T1 minus T3 divided by T3. Now, 0.7 is equal to T1, we don't know T1, minus 303 divided by 303. So, 0.7 into 303 303 is equal to T1 minus 303. So 0.7 into 303 plus 303 is equal to T1 if I transfer it this side. So T1 is equal to, what do I get? 0.7 into 303 plus 303, I get 515.1 degree Kelvin. If you want small T1, 515.1 minus 273, this will give you, if you subtract 273, it will give you 242 degree centigrade. This is the highest temperature during the cycle. So this is how it is to be done.